And then the magician said, we can do that. We can do that. We can do that too. And we came here to confront him. And he threw all of them, threw down their rods, became serpents. What did the serpent of Moses do? Swallowed them up. Swallowed them up. And then they lost all their power. All the people that want to use any power against you, they lose all that power. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper. And every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. And the righteousness is of me, says the Lord. Luke chapter 11. Luke 11, reading from verse 20. In Luke 11, verse 20, but if I were the finger of God, that finger of God, that's the finger that molded man, that's the power of God. And if I, by the finger of God, or the power of God, cast out devils, no doubt the kingdom of God is come upon you. Verse 21, Luke 11. When a strong man armed keepeth his palace, his goods are in peace, but when is stronger than he, come upon him and overcome him, he taketh from him all his armor wherein he trusted, and divideth his spoil. With the power of God in your life, you have something greater than the people of the world than they have. And this day you have overcome. Ephesians chapter 6. Reading from verse 10. Ephesians 6 verse 10. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord. There's no other way. You cannot be weak in the Lord. There's no other alternative. You cannot be timid in the Lord. There is no other possibility. You cannot be fearful in the Lord. Be strong in the Lord. All you need to do is to be in the Lord. Have His grace in your life. Have His truth in your heart. Have His power on your side. The grace, the truth, the love, the power. Get into everything. And when you are in the Lord, you become strong. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wild strategies, maneuverings, imaginations of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Isn't that what makes people afraid? Because you forget your armor. And you're looking at their armor. Because you neglect your armor. What I mean by neglect is you don't train yourself to make use of your armor. But you see those people of the world, they train themselves to make use of their armor. And because of the training they give themselves, using their armor over and over, that's why it looks like their armors are powerful. It's their training. If you will train yourself, put on the armor, and then train yourself in the use of that armor. You see what it says? It says, you'll put it on. You'll be able to overcome and stand against all the wiles and the maneuverings and the strategies and all the imaginations and the wickedness of the devil. But we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against wicked spirits or spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day. In the evil day, you'll be able to withstand. And having done all to stand, you don't run away anymore. You don't abandon your duty post anymore to stand. Stand, therefore. Having your loins got about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation, proclamation of the gospel of peace, above all taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench, how many darts? All the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication of all for all saints. Today our victory has come. Number one, the wonder of God's unlimited power. Number two, the weapon of God's unfailing power. Number three, worship at God's unshielded presence. In Acts of the Apostles, chapter 16. Acts, chapter 16, verse 25. The background story here is that Paul and Silas were in captivity, but they also come out. And they're sending Paul there this morning. And the people at Philippi put you in captivity. And last night, you couldn't sleep. And then you're saying, how long will this be? It's come to an end this morning. And Silas there, that all through the night you were thinking, you were meditating on the challenges of life. And then you began to look into the history of your life when you were young, when you went to school, when you came out of school. And you're saying, I've never gotten anything on a silver plate. It's always with sweat and tears. How is it like this? And then you drag yourself to the faith clinic this morning. Welcome. I said welcome. Worship the Lord. And as you worship the Lord, you're going to find all the yokes are broken this morning in Jesus' name. Paul and Silas, they were kept in the prison. Their legs in the stocks, their hands in the chain. And then they were sitting down on the bare ground, but their mouths were not chained, were not padlocked, and their hearts still raised up, hallelujah, glory, praise to the Lord. And so it says in Acts chapter 16, verse 25, and at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly, you will not know when your chains will fall off. And suddenly, you'll not know when the problems will be solved. And suddenly, you'll not know when the barrenness will quit. And suddenly, you'll not know when your enemies will be paralyzed. And suddenly, you'll not know when the prison doors will open wide. And suddenly, you'll not know when the miracle will take place. And suddenly, there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaking. And immediately, all the doors were opened, and everyone's bands were loose, just by worshiping God at his unshielded expresses. We're looking at 2 Chronicles chapter 20. Just worship the Lord. And in the worship of the Lord, you'll find how yokes are broken, how sicknesses are healed, how impossibilities become possible, how the afflictions and the attacks are taken away, how the sterility and the barrenness will move away, how miracle babies will be given as a gift, how blind eyes will open, how the lame will rise up and begin to walk, how your child with inability or disability that he was born with, how that disability will vanish away. Just worship, and as you worship, you'll find a miracle is there already. In 2 Chronicles chapter 20, reading from verse 20. And he rose early in the morning. We're not the first people to rise up early in the morning to worship the Lord. They rose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, Hear me, O Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, believe in the Lord your God, so shall ye be established. Believe as prophets, so shall ye prosper. You will prosper. And when he had consulted the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord, and as you praise the beauty of holiness, as they went out before the army, and to say, Praise the Lord, for his mercy endureth forever. The singers made the army unnecessary. The singers, the worshippers, who are leading in praise worship, they made all the weapons of the army of Jehoshaphat unnecessary, because they went before, and then the army came behind. And it says, as they were singing, as they were worshiping, as they were praising the Lord, saying, Praise the Lord, for his mercy endureth forever. It was a chorus. Praise the Lord, and his mercy endureth forever. It was only one line. Praise the Lord, and his mercy endureth forever. And their minds were thinking of his mercy in the time of Abraham. His mercy endureth forever. His mercy in the time of Israel. His mercy endureth forever. His mercy upon the people in Egypt. His mercy endureth forever. His mercy at the Red Sea. His mercy endureth forever. His mercy when he brought them. There was not one sick among them. His mercy endureth forever. Just one line. Praise the Lord, and for his mercy endureth forever. And when they began to sing, that's worshiping the Lord. When they were worshiping and to praise the Lord, set ambushments against the children of Ammon and Moab and Mount Seir. And when they were come against Judah, they were smitten. They were smitten. They were smitten. They have their faces on the ground. Your enemies will lick the dust. Because now you worship, and there is power. Power in praise. Power in worship. In Psalm 22. Psalm 22, I'm reading from verse 3. In Psalm 22, looking at verse 3. Here it says, But thou art holy, O thou that inhabitest the praises of Israel. He inhabits the praises of Israel. And as you worship the Lord, you not forget about your problem, because they are solved already. Forget about the enemies, they are conquered already. And forget about your sickness, you are healed already. Stand up and praise God for your healing. Stand up and praise God for your deliverance. Stand up and praise God for the miracle. You've got it already. As you are singing, as you are praising God, rejoicing before the Lord, all their bands were loose, all their yokes were broken, all their enemies were defeated and destroyed. All their problems problems were solved. All your mountains are dissolved. All the heartaches are removed. All the challenges, bring them before the Lord and praise the Lord. What a glorious thing this morning. He has delivered you already. You are set free. You come to receive from the Lord this morning, and He has come to give unto you. You come to receive from the Lord this morning, and He has come to give unto you. Praise the Lord for that. Glorify His name for that. In Jesus' name we pray. If you are free and free indeed, in Jesus' name we pray. If your enemies are knocked down to the ground and they're licking the doors and you are standing in strength, praise the Lord. If you know the hand of God is touching you right now, the might of God is with you right now, your sicknesses are taken away right now, impossibilities are becoming possible right now, praise the Lord. Raise up your hand and rejoice. Have you ever clapped your hand above your head? 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 Where are the enemies now? Where are the difficulties now? Where is Satan now? Where are the agents of Satan now? Where is your sickness now? You're free in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, we thank you today that we can rejoice in your presence.